Hello again, everybody. John Riddle here with another tutorial, and today we've got a great one for you. It's all about CorelDRAW Graphic Suite. Now, CorelDRAW is one of the most useful and professional tools out there today. You can use it on Windows and Mac OS. You can use it to create image enhancement, image correction, or vector drawings. It's very useful, very easy to use. And this beginner tutorial is brought to you by Corel Software. So let's get going. CorelDRAW Graphic Suite must not be confused with CorelDRAW Go, which is more suitable for beginners thanks to its simpler and more basic features. Check our links in the video description to learn more about CorelDRAW Graphic Suite or CorelDRAW Go. When you open CorelDRAW Graphic Suite, you get into the welcome screen showing tutorials, tips, news, and your most recent documents. Click on New to start with a new blank project or get a ready template to use. In the first case, select a preset and configure it on the right with name, number of pages, color mode, page size, orientation, and resolution. As you click on OK, the new document opens. The main interface shows the canvas, the tabs of all projects open on top, and all document pages at the bottom. On the right, you have several panels, including the Learn panel that shows tips on how to use any current tool. If any of these panels misses, you can retrieve it from Window Dockers. You can also customize the interface color from Tools, Options, Customization, heading to Appearance and then to Theme. Now let's see how to draw vector objects. Vectors are shapes defined by mathematical algorithms that never lose quality no matter how much you scale or transform them until they're rendered as pixelated images. You have several tools to draw vectors on the left. Some of these buttons collect multiple tools that you can show by clicking and holding over these. Enable the freehand tool to draw freely by clicking and dragging on the canvas, adjusting trace width and style at the top. Other tools within the same button collect other trace types you can try and use. Make sure to use Control or Command and Z to undo any drawing if you need. Another powerful tool is the painterly brush, which includes loads of artistic traces from grainy to acrylics, fluid, oils, particles, and much more, with loads of options to control your strokes, including size, pressure, smoothing, and texture. Switch to the polyline tool to drop precise shapes. Click on the canvas to drop straight segments and click and hold to define curves. To finish, close the shape or double-click on the last node. Use the three-point curve to draw smooth arcs by clicking and holding, then releasing and clicking again to finalize the curve. Whereas, enable the B-spline tool to drop curves by clicking on the canvas. Enable the Bezier or Pen tool to draw very precisely. Click to define straight segments and click and hold to draw curves that you can control through the blue tangent handles. Apply the shape by closing it or double-clicking on the last node. Furthermore, you can enable any shape tool to drop rectangles, circles, and other geometrical shapes by clicking and dragging on the canvas. You can also use the Common Shapes tool to drop other regular shapes selectable from the top. Whereas, if you have ready-made vector drawings in SVG format, you can import them from File, Import. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out and check your drawings. You can also enable or disable several drawing aids from the top, such as rulers or grids. From Snap To, you can also manage snapping options, allowing you to snap to specific borders or object endpoints, edges, or intersections while you draw. Enable the Pick tool to manage your vector drawings. Click on any object to select it, drag it to move it, and use its black nodes to scale it. Click again on the drawing to change its nodes and rotate or skew it, moving the central node to adjust the rotation point. To edit the appearance of an object, select it and use the options on top or collected within the Properties panel on the right. Open Outline to adjust line color, width, style, and endpoints type. Switch to Fill to apply a uniform fill color or any gradient. If you choose a gradient, select any marker to edit its color and transparency and move it to fine-tune the final gradient effect. You can also apply vector or bitmap patterns if you like. In the second section of the toolbar, you get several editing tools for vectors. Enable the Shape tool to adjust a vector shape by moving nodes and handles on curves, or also adding new nodes on paths by double-clicking on it. Other tools apply effects by brushing over vector drawings, such as the Smear or the Twirl tool. To add text, enable the Text tool and click and drag to drop a text box, delimiting the text content you type. If the box contours turn red, make sure to extend them with the black nodes until the entire text is visible. Switch to the Pick tool to select text and move it, double-clicking on it to modify its content. You can select text and edit font, size, style, fill, background, and outline from the top bar or the Properties panel on the right. Now, let's see how to work with bitmap objects or images. Unlike vectors, images may lose quality as they are made of rendered pixels. To import an image, go to File, Import, and browse for the file with formats including JPEG, PNG, WEBP, and PDF. Then, click and drag on the canvas to place the image with the right size. You can use the Pick tool to edit the image again if you need. To crop the image, enable the Shape tool and modify its contour. You can also apply effect tools to the image, however, only its contours are affected unless you convert the image into a vector. To do this, select the image and go to Trace Bitmap on top, which generates a vectorized version of the image over it, affected by the vector brush tools. CorelDRAW has several features for image correction. Select any image and open the Properties panel. Apply any transparency uniformly or with gradients or patterns. On Bitmap Effects, add several effects and corrections with the plus button at the bottom, tuning options while checking the canvas. On Adjust, you get all the effects for photo correction, such as brightness, contrast, saturation, and much more. These effects are applied in order from top to bottom. You can move any effect up or down by dragging it, and also enable or disable it with the eye icon. Now, let's see how to manage vectors and images with the Objects panel on the right. This shows everything you have on the canvas for each document page, collected in a single group called Layer 1. You can click on any object or an entire layer to select it on the canvas and use the eye icon to hide or show any. With the lock button, you prevent any modification, and with the FX button, you can disable or enable the effects applied to any object. If objects overlap, you can adjust their order of visibility by dragging any object up or down in the list. You can also click on New Layer at the bottom to create a second layer and collect other objects separately by clicking and dragging them onto it. CorelDRAW includes advanced effects for vectors in the sixth section on the left to add shadows, contours, or even extrusion, adjusting properties on top. These effects also follow the original shape. For example, enable the Extrude tool to apply extrusion by clicking and dragging on the object. Set the extrusion direction with the black cross and move the white bar to adjust the extrusion length. Click again to orbit the extrusion or rotate it in 2D with the green circle. These rotations also lock the direction permanently as indicated by the white cross. On top, customize the extrusion by changing its type, its color, or lighting. Click on Clear Extrude to remove the extrusion effect. To save your work, go to File, Save As, and choose a CDR format to save your document with all its drawings and layers. Select PDF to render and print your document, and SVG to save your drawings as a vector file for the web with no quality loss. You can also save your project to Corel Cloud if you need to access your designs from anywhere online. Hey, thank you very much for watching today's tutorial on CorelDRAW, and if you'd like more information about this software, be sure to click on the video description and you'll get more information on CorelDRAW. And as always, I'll say for more tips, tricks, and great tutorials about a wide variety of softwares, be sure to visit our YouTube channel or our website. We'll see you next time.